Hello friends, so today we can discuss the problem first from the latest Google Kickstart round E. The problem name is longest arithmetic. So it's the simplest problem in the whole set. Let's start the problem first. You are given an array, arithmetic, like you are given actually an array. An arithmetic array is the array in which the difference between every consecutive number is same. It's just an arithmetic progression. So what you are like asked to find out is you are given an n integers, and then the value of every integer is ai. Then you have to choose some contiguous arithmetic subarray from the array which you are given, such that it should be an arithmetic subarray. The array you are given is like some random numbers, and you have to find out a continuous arithmetic subarray which has the maximum length. An arithmetic subarray can be in which the difference between every two consecutive number is same, and you have to determine the longest length. That's the whole question. So it's a very simple problem because you just have to keep track of the differences, because the difference should be same. So what you can do, you can find a difference between every two consecutive numbers, and then you have to find out the longest consecutive subarray which has the same difference. So let's understand with this example. This is the first example set. Take this example, and what I've done is I have pushed a very large negative number in the end. Okay, now what you'll do, take a subtraction of every consecutive number. So 7 minus 10 is minus 3, 4 minus 7 is minus 3, 6 minus 4 is 2, 8 minus 6 is 2, 10 minus 8 is 2, then 11 minus 10 is 1. And like this number minus this number is very large negative number, so it's like I have written down minus 3. Now what you have to do, you have to find out the largest or longest subarray which has the same length or like the same number written on it. So as you can see, this is one subarray, this is one subarray, this is one subarray, and this is one subarray. So the largest length is 2, because it denotes the difference between every two consecutive numbers. If its length is 3, then the total length of the subarray will be 4, because like it is for two numbers, it is for two numbers, it is for two numbers. So like three numbers consecutive same, which means that there are a length of 4 subarray which is like contiguous arithmetic. So that's the whole logic for this question. Let's move on to the code part now. So the code is also very simple, in which take the input of the all n numbers, save them, then make a difference array, because if the length of this array is n, then the difference array will be n minus 1. Then the difference array is for every ith value in this difference array, it's just I plus 1 minus ai. Then we will push back a very large negative number in the end. Then we have two variables. Length is the length of the current subarray, and maximum is the maximum global maximum, the maximum length subarray you will find. Then iterate from left to right. If I is equal to 0 at the first point, just increase length. Else, if you check that, if the previous number is equal to this number, then you will keep on increasing the length. If it differs, then what you will do, you will find out, okay, now at this point it differs, so we have find out a contiguous subarray which has the same numbers. So you will check that whether this length is maximum or not. If it's maximum, store it in the maximum, or else like make our length equal to 1, because length equal to 1 means because now we are at a number which is the next change number, so we have counted this number now. So that's why we have made length equal to 1, because now if we are on this number, what does this mean? So that we have 2 2 2 and 3. So we have seen this number, or 3. Okay. And now we have seen that a continuous subarray is of length 3. Now we check this number. It is different from this number. So what we'll do, we will take that. Okay, now this is a continuous subarray, but we are on this point now. So now in the next iteration, I will go or start from this point. So I have to count this number. So I will take this number, make a length, current length equal to 1. And now check from this point. Okay, these two are equal. Okay, now current length equal to 2, and so on. So that's the whole logic for this question, and we'll return maxi plus 1, because we have to add one more character, because these are the differences, and for the actual subarray length we have to add 1. That's the logic for this first question. Stay tuned for more videos. I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.